Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off today's video, we have some more launches coming up in a couple of days with Falcon 9. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of Starlink 419 is scheduled to lift off on Friday 17th at 4:08 PM UTC or 12:08 PM EDT. Then you can see there is the launch of Sarah 1 less than 24 hours later on Saturday 18th at 1:50 PM UTC or 9:50 AM EDT. On top of that, there is even another launch of the Global Star FM15 on Saturday 19th at 4:30 AM UTC or 12:30 AM EDT. There was a tweet posted by Michael Sheets regarding the recent news of the propellant leak which delayed CRS-25. He said, NASA says SpaceX narrowed down the source of the issue in the CRS-25 Cargo Dragon spacecraft's propulsion system down to a Draco thruster valve inlet joint which the company is replacing. CRS-25 launch now targeting no earlier than July 11th, delayed from June 10th. Jeff Faust posted a series of tweets related to Starlink information from a recent conference. The first says, in a satellite constellation session at AES 240, Pat cites and notes that newer version 1.5 Starlink satellites which lack visors are about half a magnitude brighter than earlier visor sats. In a real sense, we are going backwards here. Next he posted, Sitzer adds that the proposed Starlink Gen 2 satellites designed for launch on Starship are far larger than existing Starlink satellites. It's anyone's guess what their brightness will be. Following that, there was a tweet saying, however, NRAO's Tony Beasley says that Starlink is minimizing interference in radio astronomy with observed impacts, including testing with Starlink user terminals near observatories like the VLA consistent with models. Finally, he also posted a tweet saying, Julie Davis of the American Astronomical Society notes that astronomers' concerns about the effects of satellite constellations clash with growing demand for broadband. We are not against the internet, we just don't want it to be super reflective. There was an article posted about SpaceX gearing up to activate lasers on its first batch of capable satellites. It says, on this front, SpaceX has submitted an application to the Federal Communications Commission seeking authority to activate spacecraft in polar orbits. There was another article posted related to Starlink. It says, want to use your Starlink dish on a moving boat or car? According to Dish Network, you should be booted from the network. On Monday, Dish pushed the FCC to force SpaceX to deactivate Starlink customers who have installed the satellite internet system on moving boats and cars, calling the activity illegal. Here's another article posted related to Starlink, this one also including OneWeb. It says, SpaceX and OneWeb said June 13th they have reached a spectrum coordination plan that would enable their current and second generation broadband mega constellations to coexist. Chris Burgin posted a tweet with information from the agreement itself. It says, by working together and ensuring that first round systems are protected, the parties have been able to drive more productive use of scarce spectrum resources for the benefit of American consumers and businesses. There was a recent SEC filing with information about SpaceX having raised just under $1.7 billion in their latest equity round. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. Work is going on with the orbital mount to prepare it for Booster 7's arrival again. Here you can see flame diverters on the orbital mount legs. The booster quick disconnect on the orbital mount was seen being tested. The chopstick catching arms were seen simulating a booster lift. Deliveries were spotted at the suborbital tank farm recently. Engineers have continued working on the suborbital pad B mount. Cladding is now starting to go onto the sides of the new structure near the production yard. Staff factory is continuing at the production site. Two objects were spotted being placed inside the mystery white box. Groundwork is going on at the propellant production site. We finally have some incredible news regarding the FAA programmatic environmental assessment as it has now been approved. SpaceX posted a tweet saying, one step closer to the first orbital flight test of Starship. Elon Musk posted a tweet in response to this saying, for the first time ever there is a rocket capable of establishing permanent bases on the moon and Mars. Scott Manley asked Elon Musk, so will you be adopting an ocelot? He responded and said, I'm told that no ocelot has been spotted in the Boca Chica area for approximately 40 years. We have many motion activated cameras around Starbase, thousands of clips of coyotes, dogs and cats, but no ocelots. Michael Baylor also posted a tweet about the Starship FAA review completion. He said the FAA has issued a mitigated finding of no significant impact or FONSI for orbital Starship launches from Boca Chica, Texas, effectively giving an environmental green light to the SpaceX project. The decision could face legal disputes from environmental groups. Elon Musk was asked, when's the orbital flight happening? Is July possible? He responded with, Starship will be ready to fly next month. I was in Highbay and Megabay late last night reviewing progress. Then he responded to that and said, we will have a second Starship stack ready to fly in August and then monthly thereafter. There was an article posted saying NASA wants Elon Musk's SpaceX to ensure its plan to launch its next generation Starship rocket from Florida will not put at risk nearby launch infrastructure critical to the International Space Station, a senior space agency official told Reuters. Here's the E-Dome test tank at the launch site. Ship 24 is in the high bay and may have Raptor engines installed soon. Elon Musk posted a really cool picture on Twitter of Starship 24 inside the high bay as work continues on the prototype. The closures for this week were cancelled, but there was a new date added yesterday. You can see there is an intermittent closure scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 16th, for what I assume will be a Booster 7 rollout to the launch pad. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, also known as Boca Chica Gal, and Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.